Okay, so today I'm gonna show you 5 tricks that can actually improve your FPS in Arsenal by a lot, and by a lot I mean even up to 100 FPS difference. I've made a video a while ago on this, but there are a few new tricks that I learned that helped me get more FPS, so you should also get better performance if you follow those tricks. So let's start. Okay, so the first trick is the Windows game mode. Just go to your Windows search bar and type in game mode, and this will pop up, and now you have to test it yourself. You have this on, turn it off and see if you get a little bit more FPS in Arsenal. If you do have it off, turn it on and see if you maybe get a little bit more FPS. Turn it off, turn it on, and just see if this maybe increases your FPS by a little bit. Alright, so the next thing is actually a specific full screen option in Roblox. There's actually a better full screen option that improves your FPS by a lot if you have a bad device. Now, this post was made by some devs talking about how the Alt Enter full screen doesn't work anymore. Now sadly it's closed, so I'm going to put a download link in the description of the file that you have to download to make this thing work. And don't worry, it was made by some trusted developer. I've been using this for a long time now and I've never had any issues or any virus issues. What you have to do is just right click on the Roblox app, open file location, and then you have the Roblox file. What you have to do is create a folder called client settings and paste the file you downloaded into it. You can just copy this folder and paste it on your desktop or something so you have a copy of this file, because every single time Roblox will update you have to redo this trick. So just have this file saved somewhere on your PC and then you can put it back on after a Roblox update. Okay, so as you can see, I'm in Arsenal right now, not in the full screen mode. And if I press Alt Enter, the display is gonna flash a little bit. And now I'm in the full screen mode. And if you go to the settings and you look at the full screen mode, it's turned off. And that's good. And also, I've learned this trick thanks to Draco, so shoutouts to him. And now, the next trick will require you to launch Roblox before you do this, because otherwise you don't have access to it. Open your task manager, right click on Roblox game client, go to properties, and then you have a window like this open. Go to compatibility and check the disable full screen optimizations. What this will do is this will disable some weird Windows settings that are supposed to optimize the full screen experience for you, but most of the time it will actually make you lag a bit more. And just like with the previous trick, every single time Roblox updates you have to do this once again. This can give you some more FPS and decrease the input lag. Now, something simple that pretty much everybody knows you can do, you can just go to the Roblox files once again, platform content, PC, textures, and whatever texture you have, delete all of them besides sky and those random free files at the end of the list. And that will delete the textures, which also will increase your FPS. And the last thing that can help you is opening your GPU software. Like for me, I have the AMD Radeon software where I can pretty much change all of the things. So it doesn't matter if you have AMD GPU or NVIDIA GPU, there should be a setting like anti-lag. Turn that on because this will decrease the input lag. You can also turn on something like Radeon Boost, which will kind of lower the quality of the game you're playing, which is Arsenal for example, but it should boost your FPS. You can also turn on something like image sharpening, which also will lower the quality, but will add like a sharpen filter on this so it won't look this bad. And I'm pretty sure NVIDIA software as well has something like this. You just have to find it, because I simply don't have that GPU, so I cannot show you how to do it. Pretty much all of those settings can increase your FPS. You can just change it to the lowest settings or find a tutorial on YouTube which will show the most optimized settings for like AMD or NVIDIA to get the most FPS possible. And yeah, by changing all of those settings, you should now get a lot more FPS. So hopefully this video helps you out. If it did, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. But that's it for today's video. I'm gonna head out now. Goodbye.